वेलकम बैक, यू आर वॉचिंग टू द पॉइंट। आरएसएस सांसद चालक मोहन भागवत कमेंट्स दैट हिंदुस्तान के लोग हिंदू हैं हैज इनवाइटेड बोथ द रॉथ एंड डिरिजन ऑफ हिज क्रिटिक्स बट ऑल्सो द स्ट्रेंज साइलेंस ऑफ हिज सपोर्टर्स। वेरी फ्यू पीपल इन द बीजेपी आर विलिंग टू डिस्कस दिस इशू। सो टुनाइट वी आस्क, हैज मिस्टर भागवत सिंपली गॉट हिज फैक्ट्स एंड एटिमोलॉजी रॉन्ग और इज ही मेकिंग अ बिगर एंड फॉर सम फार मोर इंसिडियस पॉइंट दैट शुड पुट अस ऑन आवर गार्ड। माय गेस्ट्स आर बीजेपी नेशनल एग्जीक्यूटिव मेंबर शेषाद्रि चारी, Congress MP and spokesperson Abhishek Singhvi, CPM Rajya Sabha MP and Politburo member Sitaram Yechuri, and senior journalist Kanchan Gupta. Mr. Chari, speaking in Cuttack on the 10th, the RSS Sangsar Chalak said, and I'm going to quote him, German logon ka Germany hai, English logon ka England hai, American logon ka America hai, Hindustan kiska hai, Hindustani log hai, is desh ke sab log Hindu hai. The problem is, Hindustan doesn't mean the land of the Hindus. It's a word of Persian origin, which means the land on either side of the Indus River. So has the Sangsar Chalak made a terrible mistake?
No, why Hindustan doesn't mean Hindustan, the land of Hindus? Hinduo ka stan, Hindustan.
But in fact, you're getting the etymology wrong.
No.
The word Hindu
etymological
in this instance comes
science.
From the Persian, which comes from Hindus, which fine. Is what they call the Sindhu River, which was the Indus.
Fine. So whatever it is, Hindu word has been given to us by the Persians. Hindu word has come much later. We all agree for this. But when we say Hindu, what we mean is what Hindu represents. If you are looking at Hindu from a political prism or from a religious prism, that is something wrong. We are looking at Hindu from a tradition point of view, from the cultural point of view.
Can I reinforce?
From the nationalist point of view. For us, Hindu is nation.
Can I reinforce my question by pointing out that in fact, the word Hindustan to refer to this land was actually popularized by the Mughals, who were Muslim emperors. They used it to refer to their domain. They certainly weren't calling the empire the land of the Hindus. They were simply using the Persian word, the land on either side of the Indus, or in this instance, the land between the Indus and the Ganges.
Yes, we have accepted that word. We have no problem accepting that word.
So then Hindustan has nothing to do with Hindus.
Like the government of India, we have accepted. Government of India has accepted the word and called it Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. They did not say India Aeronautics Limited.
So you've made that leap of faith that Hindustan is Hindus.
Yeah.
Sitaram Yechuri, let me put it like this. Even though I've been arguing that the Sangsar Chalak does not know the etymological origins of the word Hindustan, nonetheless, the point he was making is this country is hugely influenced by the original Hindu religion of this country. What do you say to people who claim that's an undeniable fact?
No, I don't think these sort of inferences are correct. Number one, you see, remember when India became a secular democratic republic, we went through a very, very serious debate in the Constituent Assembly, and Hindustan, along with Bharatavarsha, Bharatakanda, a lot of other names were discussed of what should India mean in Hindi or Sanskrit. And then finally you came to the understanding, and that's what the first article of the Constitution says, India, that is Bharat. Bharat, as we have said, precisely to escape or to not to give this wrong impression that it has got a religious connotation, that we've used the word Bharat in our constitution and not Hindustan. So that has a certain meaning. Now to call Hindustan as the land of the Hindus, and that itself, I would contest, I mean, if you go through historians of our ancient literature, even the Vedic literature, and if you tell me, I mean, anybody would like to know, where does the word Hindu get mentioned in any of the Vedas? The word Hindu as denoting a certain religious group is something that emerges much, much later. So therefore, it would be wrong to say this is the ancient land of the Hindus, or to say there's a nationality called the Hindus.
Okay.
I think that's an absolutely wrong, scientifically and historically, a conclusion to draw.
All right. Kanchan Gupta, the interpretation that I put to Sitaram Yechuri was that the underlying culture of this country is hugely influenced by its original Hindu religion. The problem is that would only be correct if culture was a static thing. It's not. India's culture has been influenced in the decades and millennia by Islam, by Christianity, by Sikhism, by Jainism, by Buddhism. As a result, It's a composite thing. You can't then reduce it to its alleged Hindu origin. That's what the Sangsar Chalak is trying to do. He's forgetting all the millennia of accretions and trying to go back to the original core.
The term Hindu is really a civilizational identity. People who have, through the millennia, lived in this land are civilizationally Hindus. Culturally, yes, I mean, to the point that culture is, like you said rightly, it's not something which is static, but you cannot disown your civilizational history. You cannot disown your civilizational past. You cannot disown your civilizational identity. And therefore, the term
Hindu... You seem to be identifying Hindu with ethnicity.
No, I am not. I'm identifying it...
The uniting civilizational factor is our common ethnicity, not necessarily our common culture.
I totally reject the suggestion of ethnicity or an ethnic identity. I am just positing that we have a common civilizational history, a common civilizational identity. And, Jawaharlal Nehru talks about the silken bond that connects the various faces of India. And that silken bond is really our civilizational and cultural history.
But that is not simply reducible to Hinduism. That's what you're trying to...
But you're confusing, Karan, you are confusing Hindu... The term Hindu with Hinduism. I am not.
All right.
I am just saying that Hindu is a civilizational, historical identity.
Let me bring it. Let me bring it.
I'll just add to this. Mohammad Karim Chagla said, I am a Hindu by culture.
So did Francis D'Souza, your deputy chief minister in Goa, but they don't have to be right because they said it.
No, it's not the question of whether right or wrong.
Abhishek, let me bring you in.
There's an interesting debate
and discussion happening here that there is a difference between Hindu and Hinduism, that Hindu is somehow the civilizational entity from which all of India, regardless of what religion they have, emerges. Hinduism is just one of the many religions some of those Indians then go on to have. Would you accept this distinction between Hindu and Hinduism and the identification of Hindu as some sort of core civilizational identity, almost as if it's an ethnicity, although Kanchan rejected that?
Well, in very theoretical, academic, philosophical terms, if you dig deep enough, you might accept it. But that's completely irrelevant. My first objection is, Karan, that what a massive waste of time and energy for the whole nation to be debating this. Why? Because the object behind Mr. Bhagwat's statement is something much more sinister. So we are not Indian citizens, we are not Bharatiya, we are not Indians, we are Hindus. Why Hindus? Because the Muslims of India must call themselves Hindu Muslims, the Christians must be Hindu Christians. Oh yes, we are talking of cultural nationalism, we are talking of civilizational. I'm asking myself, so what? Okay, we are Hindus, because I read Hindu to mean this side of the Indus. Why is it important today for Mr. Mohan Bhagwat to say that we are Hindus? Is he trying to establish that people living this side of the Indus are indulging in historical blunders by using the wrong etymology? Is that the object? Is it that benign an object? Or is he giving a class to a lecture room? The object is very simple. The object is to emphasize the religion part of it. Now, this is the typical BJP RSS style.
Okay.
Flit like a butterfly, sting like a bee. You don't have the courage of your convictions to say that actually the subtext is that everybody is Hindu in the cultural, religious, habitual, language sense. But when you are attacked or questioned, you say, oh, I'm talking of civilizational, cultural nationalism, identity. Whereas the real reason is that you want to bring in religion.
At least
have the courage of your convictions to say that.
Mr. Chari,
what a massive waste of time, not developing economics, not per capita income, telling you why dictionary meanings and etymological meanings must be corrected and we must be called Hindus.
Okay, that's a good point you're making.
What's the sequitur?
Pause a moment. I want to put your point and I want to add a little twist to it and get you to answer it, Mr. Chari. The word Hindustan, when it was first used by the Mughals, included all of Pakistan. It included practically most of Afghanistan. At some point of time, it even stretched beyond. Now, is the Sangsar Chalak prepared to accept that the word Hindustan refers to all of that, not just the areas where Hindus dominate?
No, these geographical entities keep changing. In 1947, On 14th August 1947, India was won. Then there was India and Pakistan. In 1971, Pakistan, India, Bangladesh. We do not know what is going to happen to Pakistan tomorrow. We do not know what is going to happen to the geopolitical situation in this area tomorrow. So we are not getting into that. What is more important is the civilizational aspect, the cultural aspect, the oneness of this culture, the past, which even Karl Marx is speaking about. Men make history out of what is given from the past. So we are relating this to this kind of a tradition.
There, no one doubts.
But if you want to keep on looking at it from the religion point of view, Hinduism, we are not referring to Hinduism from the religion point of view.
The point that people are questioning is, why are you using the word Hindu to define what you call the one culture that you believe is the common entity, civilizational, as he says in India?
You call it Indian, you call it Bharatiya, you call it anything else, we call it Hindu. If you have any objection,
the problem is I'll come to you, Mohan. The problem is when you call it Hindu,
we have not given that term.
For many people, when you call it Hindu, it seems as if you're actually equating it with Hinduism, even though you insist you're not, and that itself becomes difficult for them to accept. Use another word, it becomes a lot easier. Call it Indianness.
But what is the objection? What is the objection? No, when we say Indian culture, when we say Hindu, we say Bharatiya, we say Indian, we mean the same thing. Do you mean the same thing?
All right. Let me bring you in, Sita Ram Yechury, and quote to you Francis D'Souza, the Catholic Deputy Chief Minister of Goa, who just a couple of weeks ago said the following: all Indians in Hindustan are Hindus, including me. I'm a Christian Hindu. Hindu is my culture. Christianity is my religion. When I say Hindu, it means culture and not religion. That is a clear echoing of the Sangsar Chalak's position and the position as adumbrated by Seshadri Chari, and very different to yours. If a Catholic can say that, what's the problem for the Sangsar Chalak to say it?
Are you asking me?
Yes, I am.
No. The problem is that if you have Hindu as a religion, let me counterpose that to you. And number one, first, let me clarify that Marx has been wrongly quoted. It says, men make history, but not under circumstances chosen by them. So let's not talk about this. These are not the circumstances we have chosen, Mr. Chari. These are
Come back to my question.
If you are posing this question that all those who live in this part, on this side of the river Indus, are all Hindus, then why is a Bangladeshi Muslim an infiltrator and illegal, while a Bangladeshi Hindu is a welcome person returning to his land? Why the distinction between Muslim and a Hindu if all people here belong to this place called Hindustan?
That's a very good point, Kanchan Gupta. Answer it.
No.
Don't say no. Answer it.
We are talking of a specific geographical identity. I don't think there is any suggestion that the people of Pakistan should also refer to themselves as Hindus, because they chose to break away from that identity. They chose to go their way.
The word Hindustan and the geography it covers to suit your political purposes, which is extremely convenient.
But let me complete, Karan. Why are we contesting the civilizational identity? After all,
we are born
of the Indus Valley civilization. And just two minor points which I needed to make. Akanle wrote
but you
this.
Know, the point is, you still haven't answered Sita Ram Yechury's question. It's a very good question. Why object to Bangladeshi Muslims as infiltrators when you welcome Bangladeshi Hindus, if in fact the civilizational commonness is the same that has both people in it?
A Bangladeshi writer who places her civilizational cultural identity above her
We're talking about infiltration from Bangladesh.
She is most welcome over here.
We're not talking about Tasleema and Nasreen. We're talking about something else. You're deflecting again.
No, I'm not deflecting. I'm making the point that, if a Bangladeshi insists that his or her cultural or civilizational identity is more important than her religious identity, or his religious identity, is more than welcome. Akanle wrote a famous book called The Hindu Holiday. It was set...
I thought it was J.R. Halliday.
No, it was Akanle. And it was set in a Muslim king's court, he called it the Hindu holiday. It was about a tutor who comes in.
I know the book actually. I don't think that actually addresses the key issue. You're being a little literary with your flourishes.
The point which I am making is that I really don't think there's any reason to quibble over your Hindu identity as a civilizational identity. I think it's a secular identity than what Mr. Sangvi suggests.
Let me bring in Abhishek Sangvi. I want to pursue the point, convoluted as it is, made by Kanchan Gupta, that there is a core civilizational entity defined by the word Hindu, which is separate to Hinduism, which all people who have been born and bred down the millennia in this part of the world share. It's their common origin. And I want to pursue that point by putting this to you. So strong is that identity, you could argue, that Indian Muslims and Indian Christians are even today conscious of their so-called caste origin. In fact, in Pakistan, you find people conscious of their caste origin. You find people who even marry in terms of what they believe is their caste identity, and yet they're Muslims, and caste is an anathema to them. And so I put this to you. Doesn't that suggest that the foundational conditioning influence of the subcontinent is this common Hindu origin?
Karan, let's take the bull by the horns, and let's not try to, make fine distinctions in an academic sense. Remember, Mr. Bhagwat was not giving a lecture in university, or is not a teacher. Please understand the purpose behind it. I'm asking you a question, Karan, or through you a question. Assume Hinduism was not a religion at all, and only designated a geographical area. Do you really think that Mrs. Bhagwat, Mr. Chari, or Mr. Kanchan Gupta would be interested in using the word Hindu? Now, the point is simple. Let me accept for a moment that yes, originally Hindustan meant a purely geographical connotation. Let's put it in perspective. Originally, as a lot of things mean different, it meant a geographical connotation. What is the sequitur or the point Mr. Bhagwat is making? Why is he, in the middle of all the crises and all the problems we have in this country, interested in making the point that we must start calling ourselves what originally 10,000 years ago this area was geographically known as?
Okay.
Obviously and only because that is the religious connotation which he's interested in. He is ignoring, and you are told today by these two persons here that you must be in an ivory tower, ignore the true contextual meaning of Hindu in the last 500,000, 2,000 years. And go back to an arcane, academic, unreal meaning,
Abhishek,
just to defend yourself.
Permit me to put a journalistic point to that very good argument and ask you to answer it. What he's really saying is this, that this is not simply an academic, civilizational point that the Sangsang Chalak is making. It is perhaps the thin end of an insidious Hindu wedge. It is an attempt, A, to undermine Indian secularism, and B, to try and push and promote India as a Hindu country. That's why this emphasis on the word Hindu, when you want to in fact define something that you already accepted is Indianness, but you're defining it as Hindu.
See, the Sarsanga Chalak is saying what Lala Lajpat Rai said, what Swami Vivekananda said, and what Mahatma Gandhi said. Mahatma Gandhi said, Hinduism is a relentless pursuit of truth. That is what he said. He did not say, my religion is Hindu. He did not equate Hinduism with religion. And that is what the Sarasanga Chalak is also saying. That is what the RSS has been saying. We are not limiting. If you,
you
want
know,
to look at Hinduism only from the religious prism.
The problem is this. The word Hinduism is the name of a religion. You're using the same word Hinduism to define civilizational culture.
We don't accept. Because we have accepted it for 60 years, just because the Britishers gave us the term religion, it doesn't mean Hinduism, dharma and religion are different. They are two very different connotations. They have two very different meanings.
Okay. See that,
and that is why when Bertrand Russell wrote about it, he said, he named his book Western Religion and Eastern Thought. He did not say Eastern Religion.
Sitaram, do you want to come in at that point and answer this particular point that Hinduism is not a religion, it is a civilizational concept, that the religion, even though it's called Hinduism, should perhaps be called something else to avoid confusion, and therefore the word Hinduism is used for two separate things: religion on the one hand by some people, Mr. Chari would say wrongly, and also for this civilizational concept that is the core of the subcontinent, and the word is common to both.
Explain to me. I mean, you've not answered my question regarding Bangladeshis, but just imagine that here you have a country, Bangladesh, that accepts Rabindranath Tagore as their national poet, guru, and the spiritual leader. They accept his poem as their national anthem. They swear by his name and follow him all through along. Now, if there is no cultural commonality, but still, why is a Bangladeshi Muslim a Muslim and he is not welcome in India? And why is a Bangladeshi Hindu welcome as somebody who is returning home?
Answer it this time.
Very simple.
He didn't answer it, you answer
the
it.
The Bangladeshi Hindu is unwelcome, unwanted in Bangladesh. He is unwanted in that place. That is why the Bangladeshi Hindu is coming here.
Why is he unwanted there? Because he's a Hindu?
That is because he is a Hindu.
It's perceived as a religion.
For him.
But in your eyes, it's not a religion.
For the Bangladeshi Muslim who fought against the Pakistanis because of the language, now his identity is shifting from language to his method of worship. And when there is a clash between this method of worship, this comes up. I am not against Bangladeshi Muslims if they are coming to this country for an economic reason. Let them come here, let them have work permit, work and go back, or they earn here, they live here. I want them to associate with the traditions of this country.
Come back.
Just as Mohammad Karim Chagla said, any Bangladeshi Muslim who comes here and says, I am a Hindu by culture, this country is mine.
Can I put this to you?
I welcome it.
If you believe that there is a core civilizational entity that is common to every single person born and brought up in this land through the millennia, and that it imbibes all the influences this country has seen in religious terms, Hindu, not just Hinduism, Christianity, Islam, Jainism, Buddhism, whatever, then call it by a name other than Hindu so that you don't mislead and you don't confuse. Call it Indianness.
No,
you call it anything.
Why can't you?
You call it anything.
Because you identify Indian as Hindu. That's the problem.
Let me tell you one thing. We have no problem calling it Indian. But when we say Indian and when we say Hindu, does it mean the same thing is the question.
To many people, it doesn't mean the same thing, and that's why there's confusion. You'd make it much simpler if you used Indian.
No,
people don't equate Indian with Hindu.
Tomorrow they are not going to accept. They are not going to accept that. You first accept that Hinduism, Indianism, Bharatiyatva, all these are all. If
Abhishek
India is equal to Bharat, why cannot India be is equal to Hindu?
Because Hindu connotes with the religion.
If the government of India can have Bharat Heavy Electricals and Hindustan Aeronautics at the same time,
why not this? Okay.
If the Abhishek government can equate Hinduism,
let me come back to the key issue, because this is going to have to be the last question, and I'm going to ask you for a very simple, short answer. If they were to use Indianness rather than Hindu for this core civilizational entity that is common to all people born and bred in this land, would it be acceptable to you? Indianness rather than Hindu.
Karan, this is exactly why I was interrupting for the last 5 minutes. I can prove to you in 30 seconds. I challenge my two friends there and Mr. Bhagwat. Please use that we are all proud Indians, proud Bharatiyas. You can even say proud Bharatvarshi, Bharatvarshi. You can say Indianness. I can wager a bet with you, Karan, on this program. They will not agree. They will say it must be Hindus. Now the cat is out of the bag. You know why.
All right.
Please call ourselves
very quickly.
Proud Indians,
I've got 10 seconds. Can you call it Indianness? Did you say no?
I am saying no to both Indianness and Bharatiya. Indianness because it is the defining culture.
I don't have time for an answer. No one will have to do. I'm out of time.
For all the Indians living
okay
abroad,
with Bharatiya, which has a Vedic root.
No. For all
and
the Indians,
you are not okay with Hindu, which has a civilizational root.
For all the Indians living abroad, Abhishek Manu Singhvi's father gave a word, Bharat Vanshi. We accepted it.
All
Abhishek
right.
Manu Singhvi's father gave me that word.
Time,
we have accepted
time,
that word.
We're returning an answer with what looks like a little hidden compliment to his father. Even if Abhishek is smiling, I don't think he likes it as
but
a riposte.
My father did not say that everybody here, Muslim, Christian, and anybody else should call
the Hindu. He wrote an article about that in Organizer. I published it, sir.
We are hugely over time.
Yes,
this
Bharat
is a consensus issue that goes to the
Indian
very
origin,
core
Bharat
of the way we see ourselves
origin
and the way we describe ourselves. At the end of the day, it goes to the very core of what what we consider our identity, which is why it is such an explosive subject and so difficult to contain in a 25-minute discussion. My thanks to all of my guests for joining me and for the valiant effort they've made. My thanks also to Sitaram Yechury, who incidentally joined us on his birthday, much against the wishes of his wife, and I'm deeply grateful to both of them.